praise. You're such a wonderful person, do you know?
Dating you has been nothing short of amazing. You have made me the happiest man alive. Since I met you, you've been nothing short of amazing, and I'm glad for that. I really do love you.
I love you too, and you know that.
Thank you. You know, a time comes in a man's life when he's right to settle down. I know you and I have discussed marriage a couple of times.
So, why are you like us to say what you want to say?
My family is mounting a lot of pressure on me.
Then tell them you are ready.
Of course they know I'm ready. It's the girl.
I'm ready too. I knew I was going to spend the rest of my life with you. That's why I accepted your ring.
But that's the problem here. You're not a girl.
I don't understand.
My family does not approve of our marriage.
Your family does not approve? What do you mean by that, Ekene? You are the one to make the decision, Ekene.
It's not that simple. I'm an only son. And you know what that means in this part. My mother and sisters have a huge stake in whatever and whoever I decide to spend the rest of my life with.
Do they?
Yes.
Do they?
I love you honestly. You know that.
I've always knew that it would come to this point. But hope that one day you stand up as a man. But it's fine. You are your mama's boy. Yes.
I'm sorry.
Do you know what, Ekene? There's no problem. It's fine, Ekene. Let your mother look for a nice girl for you to get married to. I wish you a wonderful life.
Listen to me, praise, wait, wait.
Why did you break up with her? You told me you were going to take her to your parents' home to see them.
We did that last week.
Then what happened?
My mom and sisters say that she's not suitable for me.
Oh, that's powder dash.
This is the third girl I'm bringing before my mother, and this is the third girl she's rejecting.
I don't understand. I take a girl home to see my mother, and she says I can marry her. Oh, she has to give me a reason. And her reason has to be very cogent. Else I'll go ahead and do my thing. I'm the one to live with the girl, not her.
If it were only my mother I have to contend with, it would have been easier. But my sisters seem to be in league with her.
This is serious. I think we have to do something about this.
Yeah, we do. Because all my life, they have done nothing but lead me on like a dog on leash. I had to tell the poor girl to go ahead and move on with her life. I wouldn't have to keep her down because of my people.
I think sometimes it's good to take a firm stand. We have to do something about this.
I think think he's a nice guy. Like, for now, that's what I think.
For sure he's a nice guy. Do you know what? He's been my friend before I met and even started dating James. He's a cool guy. Do you like him?
So, why doesn't he have a girlfriend?
Well, just like you, he's been in and out of relationships, just the way you behave.
You know that's not true. You don't just decide about a guy on your first date.
Okay. Why not we go this way? Let's go there and start up something. Have I ever introduced you to someone whose weight is not worth in gold? If I am not in a relationship with James and he asks me out, I will rush in and accept him without thinking twice because he's cute, he's rich, he's everything. Oh. Let's go.
Come on, James.
Sweetheart, can't just wait.
James. I can see that Ekene is drunk. Andoloma, my friend, likes him. Listen, forget about all that love song he's singing to her. Please, I do not want him to break her heart at all. Do you hear me?
Not to worry, okay? I assure you, if there's anything I see in his eyes, it's love. He's madly in love with her.
Tia, please don't be interrupted. Don't break my own heart.
Spare me. That's that.
Hello?
Hello.
How was your night?
You should be having a hangover right now. After you drank 5 bottles of beer.
Thinking about you has removed the hangover from my head.
You were. So you mean I'm now a hangover expeller?
I really had a great deal of fun last night.
Me too. I laughed so hard last night. As a matter of fact, my ribs still hurt. You know what? I think you should try comedy.
Wow, you're the reason for your aching ribs now. You know how that is, but I can be of help, you know.
Like what?
Like giving you a tender massage and soothing those nerves and veins and making you feel okay.
You have started again.
Okay, you know, I tell you what we'll do. Let me take you out for lunch today. I know a very good and quiet restaurant in town where we can go and talk.
That sounds interesting. Okay. I'm free this afternoon.
Don't eat anything at all because I intend to feed you fat today. You're skinny.
Hello. I thought most guys love skinny women.
Not someone like me who would want to have some flesh around. I don't want a skinny babe around me, so I'll be looking for her and be asking, baby, where are you? Where are you?
May God help you.
He has helped me already.
You know what?
Looking at you, one wouldn't know how funny you are. You look so
calm and quiet.
But I'm calm and quiet.
Oh, you're right. Tell that to the Marines.
Okay, well, next I travel to the States, I'll do that.
Oh, God.
You know what? Text me your address, I'll pay you a visit, okay?
Yes, sir. I will.
Last night was very hazy for me. I was seeing trees.
Do have a lovely day. Bye.
Ekene?
Hello, isn't it?
Are you home?
Yes.
Do you have food in the house?
No.
Okay, I want to go to Sister Dako's house. But I want to bring something for you. Food for you. When I'm going, I'll just pass by your house and drop it. Hope you love some jollof rice. You're home. Are you not going to work today? Perfect. Cool. So just dress up before I come so that we just go together and play with our sister's kids. I don't get you. Any kids? They're your nieces and nephew. What do you mean by any kids? Really? Who is she? Ekene, if my brother is seeing somebody, I want to know the person. Who is she? So I'll help you from making mistakes. You know you are women. Eh? Hello? Hello? Ekene? You'll never learn.
Lovely place.
Yeah.
I haven't been to this place since I got into this town.
I have my ways.
Meaning you take too many women out?
What do you think?
What do you want me to think?
Well, I know James and Mabel must have told you a lot about me, but what I do not know is what exactly they told you about me. I'm just coming out from a breakup with my ex, and I'm not looking for someone to date at the moment. They told me a lot about you too. Yes, they told me you were beautiful, and it's evident.
And what didn't they tell you?
They didn't tell me you were this witty, exciting, and have a huge sense of humor, and I find that attractive in a woman.
It's okay. My turn now. Well, I'm equally coming out from a relationship of 2 years. And this is my way of trying to unwind.
What happened?
It wasn't just going anywhere.
So, how fast do you want this to go?
You are the man. The decision rests on you.
Do I take that to mean I'm at liberty to determine the pace and maybe pacing it a bit?
I am a woman who knows what she wants. That's it.
What do you want?
Figure that out yourself. So, how is work?
Work is fine.
There was some pushing. Such a lovely apartment you have here.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
This is lovely. You've got taste, I must say.
You can say that again.
It's cozy. I love it. I love everything. I love the furniture. I love everything. Nothing I won't do to be beside you.
But standing where I am now, she's like a long memory.
When did you break up with her?
The answer will have to wait, because I have something else on my mind.
And what do you have on your mind?
You just arrived, my place, so. You're the answer to my prayers, and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. You, 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 you
James, how's it going?
Tell me, how did it go with Olomi? My ears are itchy.
It went well.
Oh, I won't take that for an answer. I want a detailed answer. My ears are itching. Talk. No.
For a young man, you're very inquisitive.
I agree. But at the same time, tell me how it went.
Anyways, it went fine. I vetted her over on Saturday. Mm-hmm. Went out, got back to the house, had fun, one thing led to the other, and then, you know, it was nice.
You mean she spent the weekend in your place?
Mm-hmm. That girl is not just good in bed, she's fantastic as a person.
She made sure she cleaned everything in my house, put everything in place, and left my house sparkling. Plus, she made me the best stew I ever ate in my life.
I thought as much. That's my man.
Yeah, bro.
Your man.
I'm your man.
Yes, yes, that was what happened.
And?
What again? What do you want to know?
You guys made out, right?
We made love.
Mm-hmm. She did what?
Yes, we did. I mean, all through the weekend, we didn't even step out of the bedroom up until this morning he brought me back to school.
And what did your mom say?
My mom? I told her I came to your house.
Oh, thank God I didn't go to your house.
Hold on a second. You didn't get my text message.
I saw it this morning. Would James allow me to see the light over the weekend? He wouldn't. Well, you should have at least called to let me know what was going on. He just blanked out, just like that.
How? Oh. I really do not know what is happening to me.
What is happening to you?
I mean, I'm still thinking. How could I have jumped into bed with a man I'm just meeting on our first date? It's very unlike me, really. It's very unlike me.
And what could that be?
I don't know, but I feel lost when I'm around him. I feel like wrapping myself all over him. Could this be love?
So what is it?
I can't tell, Andrew.
Can they write?
Hello.
Hello, my princess. How is my princess doing today?
Very well, thank you. And how has your day been going?
I'm fine, just as work. I'm attending to the things I need to do. So.
Oh, please stop joking and do the job you're paid to do.
For real, I'm not joking. I'm serious. Mine is distracting.
Why?
Because I see your face everywhere. My computer screen, on the table, my telephone, on the files, everywhere. Look around, your face stares me right in my eyes.
Stop flattering me, please.
I'm not flattering you, honestly.
Make sure you get something. I don't want you getting hungry in that office of yours.
Okay, please, take a cab and come straight to my office so we'll go home together. Is that cool?
I'll do just that.
See ya. Mm-hmm.
Same here, I love you too.
Really? Babes, now you have the answer to your question. Someone is in love.
Yes, I'm in love. He makes me feel so special.
Wow. Okay, now you have to tell me what's going on. Mm. And you too. Let's go to lecture.
Love her, go.
Really?
Let's go.
You don't look happy. What's wrong?
Nothing of importance.
Whether it's important or not, I'd like to know it, please.
You are too curious.
It is only the cat that it kills.
I was just wondering, what happened to your ex? Why did you guys break up? Just wondering why a girl would leave a man so sweet and loving like you.
Truth is, it wasn't her fault. You give me too much credit. I was the reason for the breakup.
Your fault? Is it that she wasn't good enough for you?
On the contrary, she was everything a man would ever ask for in a woman. We were already making arrangements, and
honey, I'll be traveling tomorrow.
Today?
To see my mother. It's been about a month I last saw her, and you know how it is when I haven't seen her in a while.
How do you expect me to cope without you over the weekend?
You're not coping without me. You're coming along with me.
I don't get you.
What do you mean by that?
See, I think it's about time you met my family. You and I have been dating for a while now, so I think we should go see my mom, see my siblings. I guess you know where I come from.
I'm not going anywhere with you. You haven't said anything to me yet.
Anything like what? You see, honey, I've been waiting for a very special moment to do this. You know how it is. But on a second thought, I feel there is no moment more special than this time when we are both together. So let me humbly ask you to marry me. Please be my wife.
Again, I was only teasing you.
I'm serious. Serious. Please.
No, I'm going to marry you.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Thank you so much, baby. Come here.
So beautiful.
I love you so much, you know that. You're the best thing that ever happened to me.
So are we going to the village together? Say yes.
Arthritis, the thing is still affecting me. In short, the last time your sister was here, she bought me some medicine. Okay. Man, the medicine is not helping the arthritis. If you give her an apatra, on what respect for any kind of medicine I'm
don't worry. You. Don't worry, Mama. It will have respect now because I'm here.
Oh, yeah? I believe you. good evening. You people are here. No. Yeah. Let's go inside
okay.
Now.
Girl Zoma, I have some things in the boot.
I sent Uzoma to the market to buy some things for me to make soup, as if I knew you were coming.
Hey!
Na Josiah, no soup, unchoy men.
Coffee cheese.
Ora.
Hey! Hey!
Come on, Eta.
Hello!
Mama, Chinenye. I cannot wait.
Uh-huh. Mama, tell him if I was your mother, he'll bring out the things.
Okay. Mama,
you're going.
You're welcome to my place.
Hey. Anna!
Oh, we were Mangala.
And then they say Mangala.
What's up, Mama? What's up? Mama, we don't get them like this in the city.
That is why I always tell you to come home more often.
Eh, Ejo? It be me literally very fresh.
I knew it wouldn't be long before you went back to your very, very, very usual topic.
But you see, if you get married, at least your children and your wife will come and visit us while you keep busy. Okay?
No problem. Uh-huh. That is why I have come with praise. Because I'll be getting married soon.
I was actually going to ask you who she is.
She's a girl I want to marry, Mama. What is it?
I didn't say anything.
Okay.
Where is she from?
Ah, Okonyibo. She's from Amaraku, Owerri.
Owerri.
Yes.
Ah. Ada atagra not.
Otorita.
Okay. Amaraku. What does she do?
Mama, this girl in Enanya is the marketing manager of one of the biggest hotels in the city. What do you think about it?
Omaka.
Omualuaka.
Yeah.
Na lolo.
Na hotel. Manager, hotel city.
Amakwe amao. Amwe amana da hotel.
Amwe. And I'm sure, you know, I like you.
I like you.
And I'm sure a lot of people like you too.
Yes.
Then I be at the hotel like you, okay?
Yes.
Yeah, I got Molo. When you're not in the hotel, now I'm Molo. I'm going to put you quite a Molo. No, ma'am. You're welcome.
I like you
very much. Molo. Molo Hotel.
She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she.
Hi, hi.
Hey, love, how are you?
I'm fine, baby. How are you doing?
I'm fine. How have you been?
Fine. Your mom is such a peaceful person.
Yeah, she is.
And she has a sense of humor.
Yeah, you can say that again. I'm glad you like her and she likes you too. Honey, you know you'll be staying alone in this room tonight, are you?
I know, I understand.
I'll be sleeping in the next room, just the next door. That used to be my other sister's room before she got married. I don't think anybody has used it since she moved into her husband's house. But in any case, if there's anything you need, just let me know and you'll have it, okay?
Okay, baby, I'm very comfortable. Besides, this is going to be my husband's house.
Yeah, right. Take care of yourself, okay? Mm-hmm. I miss you.
Miss you, my dear.
Okay, baby. See you in the morning.
Okay.
Alright, take care of you. Bye. Bye-bye. My love got a flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me. Cause I like him so, 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 so.
How I love got a flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me. You're awake already. Morning, how was your night?
Morning.
Mine was good. I had fun. I was just. Mama, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Morning. Good morning.
How are you?
I am fine. And I slept very well.
Oh, good.
Alarum can do a bomb, see alarum.
Good.
It's sweet.
Mama, how is Uzoma? Where is he?
Uzoma. Okay, Uzoma. He's at the backyard.
Oh, fine. I want him to boil me some water to take my bed.
Boil you some water?
Yes, Mama.
Okay, for you?
For me.
Okay. It's alright, he will boil for you.
At the backyard?
But you can...
I can't go there to see her back. Honey, I'm coming, eh?
Okay.
Alright.
Hey, I'm passing. When somebody is passing, you hold up.
Did they teach you? See, let me tell you something. When somebody is passing, you wait.
Akuchaniaja. Eh?
Sorry.
Do you know how to boil water?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I was wondering. You boil water in the hotel? Okay, for the night.
Hey, Mama.
Yeah.
You're almost ready.
Okay.
Are you not going to church?
Have you forgotten I told you we're traveling back this morning? Okay. If I go to church, that means our journey will be at night. And you know I don't like driving at night. Yes. Moreover, Praise is a Roman Catholic, so I don't think she would be accustomed to our way of worship in church.
My fair man.
Yes. All right. That reminds me, Mama. You've not told me your impression about her.
That girl is definitely not for me. I'm on walk on her. Hey! Or where again? You must go find a woman can do it. Ah, they will go for it. Or where the girls, they walk around everywhere looking for men. Ha-ha. Coupled with the fact that this one works in a hotel. Manages the hotel in Nambano. This is like bringing Akunakuna into your house. Because as she's managing hotel, she'll be managing the men, everything inside the house and outside the house. So I'm gonna walk.
Mama, what kind of talk is this now?
Shout one at me. Don't even shout at me. I'm trying to be a good mother to you. As my only son, you cannot go out there and just marry anything you see. Look at that girl. A woman should wake up early in the morning and boil hot water for her husband to have a bath. Odinalina la rola. Eh? What are we even talking about? Now let me tell you, this girl is not the right girl. When the right girl comes, I will know. Faba Akunike, hotel something. Besides, she's a Roman Catholic, I know my Anglican. Okay, tell me, when you people are about to get married, which church will you go to? Or CMS Kuno Geche, Konkende, Father? No, answer me now. Then, when my grandchildren finally come, and I get ready to go to church with them, Hasimune, bye-bye, we are going to Catholic. More as if I'm going to Anglican. Nam, I'm on walk.
Is there any girl I have brought back to this house that you have not found fault with? Is there one I will bring that you will not find fault with?
That is because you've not found the right person. If you bring the right person, I won't come here. Once I see the person, I will know she's the right person and I will accept the person. Besides, I know what is happening to this generation. All their marriages either has a crack or breaks down. And I don't want your marriage to have any crack nor breakdown. As my only son, I want a perfect marriage for you. So I know what I'm doing. See, once you bring the right woman, once I see her, I will know. If any in Agaba, I will support you.
If you make it up, na mama no one can achieve mama. I won't be far can guy yali go. I won't go this thing can guy yali. I
won't come here again. I'm not a switch.
I won't be far can guy yali.
I'm not for my switch. Of course one. Nonsense. Abuna. Hotel manager. Or where? Or hotel. 2-in-1. Ole. Oh, Kifi Yano. Then no, go, Ukochuku, go, Bebele, Ebele. If I can't have a good name.
I like him so. How I love when the flow. And how she be.
Baby, is Mama ready?
Yes, she's ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready can be.
I can see.
You look sad. What's the matter?
Nothing. There's nothing to be sad about. I'm fine.
Okay. Baby, you have to go and get dressed.
Okay, let me get my stuff.
Okay. I am bigger. I'm not going to be rejected like a side of beef.
Mama, you are ready?
Yes. Ekene told me you people will be going back later today.
Yes, Mama. We have to leave on time because we don't be very busy.
Oh, Maka. You will have a safe journey.
Thank you, Mama. Mama, thank you for accommodating me.
Oh, you're welcome.
I really enjoyed my stay.
Yeah. Yes. It's all right,
Mama,
please.
You're giving me?
Yes.
Hey. John, I don't like taking money from you.
You're not
people
now, so it's okay.
Mama, at least you can use it to get yourself some provision. When do you want to kill it out for your wishes?
Hey, thank you. Yes, Mama, thank you. Hi, Nnem. You really know how to be nice to people.
Yes.
You know, you're a good manager.
Yes.
That is why you manage people very well. In whatever capacity.
Yes.
It's all right. You can, okay, call again, yes.
Okay.
Call again, Nnem. This one is called Bribery and Corruption.
Baby, what is wrong with you?
Nothing.
You can't tell me that. You've been moody since we left the village. You hardly talked to your mom before we dropped her in the church. Why? What is it?
I'm just thinking about work. It's nothing.
You know you are a poor liar, Ikini. I know you're angry because your mom does not love me.
How do you know that?
It's very obvious. Yes. I'm not a kid. I noticed it. See, Ikini. What makes a man is his ability to make a decision and stand by it. Yes. That we are going to stay together lies in you. It's me and you that is going to live together as husband and wife, not your mother. So whatever decision you take, I'm standing behind you. Yes.
Thank you.
So, share.
Stop!
Hi, nurse.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Is my sister around?
I think you should go to our office and wait for her. She went on the ward round.
Okay, then, fine.
Where is he? You mean him?
Yeah.
He's Dr. Ezine's younger brother.
Is he a doctor too?
No, he's a banker.
I didn't see any ring on his finger.
Wait! You've surveyed him? Just like that?
Yes.
Oh, no. Well, he's not yet married. Maybe you want to propose to him.
He's looking so cute. Wow, he's my kind of man.
All right then. If truly you like him, like you say, why not talk to Dr. Izine? She can connect you to him. Yes.
I'm going to talk to her. Seriously. He's just my kind of man.
Wow.
I can't wait.
Sister girl, wake up from your dreams, please. I need things to do. Continue with your work. See ya.
So what did she say?
That she's not suitable for me. She's a Roman Catholic. And she works in a hotel. And then that she's from Owerri. What's the meaning of all of those?
I should ask you that question. What is in that thing that she told you that you do not understand?
Are you supporting her?
Ekene, I know my mother. She will not see a good girl and tell you not to marry her. It's not possible.
How can you talk like this? You don't even know this girl. How can you be so emphatic about somebody you have never met?
I do not need to meet or even know her. Oh, you want to marry a girl that is from Owerri? I could know Owerri. Eh? Then a girl that is even a Roman Catholic. Eh? You want to start having children that will be fathered by different neighbors, different men that come to that hotel. Is that what you want? You cannot just wake up one morning, see a girl on the street and just pick her and say, Mama, I found a wife, I want to marry. Is that how you do it? It doesn't work that way. It doesn't son work that way. Some of all these girls are gold diggers. They will just come into your family, destroy the family, and they make you look like a fool before your people. Doesn't work that way. Ekene, Mama has told your mind. And sincerely, I am with her on that. That simple.
All of you are impossible.
Ekene!
Who will they get? Can't walk.
I understand how you feel. I personally stood against other girls you've brought home for reasons you are well aware of. There's no need getting upset at Ezinne and Mama. If it is possible for a sister to marry a brother, Ezinne would have married you herself. And don't forget you also stood against the young man she wanted to marry.
Why would she want to marry that kind of a man?
They love each other. And don't forget that the young man was a medical doctor. They could have made progress easily if they were together. Be that as it may, why don't you send your girlfriend across this weekend? Let her come and stay the weekend with us. By that, I can assess her. If she's suitable, I'll talk to Mama. Maybe make her change her mind. There's no need getting upset. Relax and eat your food. I want to go and make food for my husband. He said he would love to eat rice and stew when he comes back. So I'll be busy in the kitchen. Yeah.
Oh yeah, Kwekwa. I hope she agrees to meet her.
There is no... All I'm saying is,
just go and stay the weekend with her. It's not an issue, it's not a big issue.
So what's the big deal in going to stay with her for the weekend?
Everything, Ekene. I am not a side of beef that should be examined by everybody before it's sold. You asked me to go with you to the village. Yes, I did. Only for your mother to start behaving as if I was picked from the gutter.
Don't talk like that. Mama treated you well.
Oh, yes, she did. You think I did not overhear what you guys were saying? She said I was from Owerri. That automatically makes me an harlot. I am also a Roman Catholic, Ekene. That automatically sends me to hell because all Roman Catholic worship the devil. And I work in the hotel. Oh. That is against the gods of your lands too.
Will you stop being melodramatic? That's an old woman you're talking about. You know women, you know how they behave. It's typical of them. Whenever their sons want to get married, they make sure they want to find out everything about the girl. That should be what you should hold on to. You know that. All I'm saying is, just make out time. At the end of the day, I'm the one who has a final say. I'm the one who decides who I'm getting married to. Just make out time. Go stay with my sister.
So at least...
So she can assess me for her golden brother. Right?
That is not true.
And if I'm found wanting in any way, she can tell you that she should drop me like a bag of fufu.
You know that is not true. They're just caring for their own. That's what it is. It's not a big deal. Honestly, left for me, there's no issue in doing this. Like I told you, I love you, and you're the one I want to spend the rest of my life with. Okay? If this is what we're going to do to make this happen, I'll gladly do it. Why don't we just do it and let it go? Nebiko on. Biko on. Nebiko on. Please. Go on. Go on.
That's my husband. Praise. Praise, please help me with the gate. Didn't you hear the horn? Help me with the gate. My husband is back. Yes. Quick. And make sure you bring in whatever he comes back with. So check the boot.
I was coming to clean the kitchen anyways. It's just a plate. You can now go and sleep. Let me handle it. Don't worry.
Auntie, please let me just finish. Come on. Stop. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Just wash your hands.
I'm sorry.
I said it's all right.
Don't worry. I'll clean it.
The girl is nothing but a bumbling idiot.
Only one night in my house, and she almost broke all the plates in my kitchen. She doesn't know how to cook nor do any other house chores. Can you imagine that my husband came back and was running at the gate? And this young lady was busy in the sitting, playing with her phone, chatting all kinds of people. I called her and called until I came and tapped her. I removed the earpiece from her ear to tell her to go and get the gate for my husband. If you see how reluctantly she stood up from my own sofa to go and get the gate, like she was the Queen Elizabeth herself. Boy, let me tell you, if that is the kind of girl you want to marry, you are completely on your own. Because Adako will not be a party to idiocy.
She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she be my one and only.
I will send her phone to bring some food for you.
She did this how, she did that how. But I cannot leave her now. You better mind yourself, my baby be that to you.
So
I like
how our love could flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so. How our love could flow. Anyhow she be living.
It does not matter for how many years you have dated my son.
The bottom line here is that we all want the best for him.
This is the most heartbreaking thing I've experienced in my life, Mama.
Your life? How long alive, Mama? Nnem, please, how old are you?
I am old enough to know that a man that I've loved and cared for so many years, now his family decides that I'm no longer good enough for him.
I don't want to sit here and cry with you. I'm coming. Let me excuse me. I'm coming.
What? She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she be my one and only, my super baby. She did this how, she did that how, but I cannot leave her now. You better mind yourself, now my baby be that to you.
So, my daughter, you're still here. Ah. You know, I'm a peacemaker. I am a very loving person. Yeah? And I wouldn't want to get angry. So I will ask you to kindly leave my compound, please. I need to make a call. Very important.
Mama, please, can I say
please,
something?
Pico, listen. Don't even say anything. Please, I don't want to manhandle you. Just carry your beautiful self and leave my compound, oh? Don't let the tears drop in my compound. Oh, you just catch it. Thank you. Mama.
Hello?
Hello, Mama.
Mm-hmm. Now the latest has happened.
You're not sounding well at all. What is it? Hey, ho. What? Is she mad? Yeah? Push her out of that house. Push out of that compound. You have to push her out, oh. Please, let me attend to baby, oh. Biko. Thank you. Oh, this cough. Mfong! Mfong! Mfong!
Ma!
Please, come with the hot water. Okay. Be quick.
So, where is she now?
I don't know. She blocked me. I went to where she used to live. They said she had moved out with no forwarding address. I just couldn't locate her. I felt she had even left town because most of my friends knew us together, so she couldn't take it. She must have been terribly devastated.
It wasn't your fault, really. Besides, I feel there was something your sisters saw, which you didn't see.
What did they see? Did they see the same thing in a woman?
Who is a woman?
The second girl I should have married.
What happened again?
Another long story.
I came to see Mama too.
Oh, is she in?
Yeah, she's inside.
Oh, good. Ewoma, meet Ezine, my elder sister. She's a medical doctor.
Wow.
Ezine, Ewoma.
Good afternoon.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Let's go and see Mama inside.
This way. I like him so, 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 so. the flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love got the flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love got the flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so.
Hello, Ezi.
Sister. Sister, good afternoon. Are you still coming here this evening?
I'm already on my way. Is there any problem?
Perfect, sister. Please, hurry up and come here now because a guy just walked in here.
Has he said anything why he wants to see us?
No. But
he came in here with one girl like that, looking like one mommy water.
You know, I think that is the reason.
Mommy water, kwa. Yeah.
Sister, sister, I'm not joking. You need to see this girl.
She is looking off just here from the rivers.
If this girl is working, on her chan, eh? What I don't understand is where Ekene goes to get all these kind of girls from.
Eh? He cannot just go somewhere, get a very good girl and marry a decent girl for a wife. I don't get it.
Even he said her name is Osino.
He won't man. What kind of a frightening name is that?
That name is frightening now. Eh? Is that one a name?
A woman. Is that an Igbo name?
Yeah. Sister Ejukwam. How would I know? I don't know.
Don't worry. When I get to the house, I will see her. Has Mama seen her yet?
I don't know. They just walked inside now.
But do you know, if not for one thing, I would have stopped them from going inside.
They do not say, eh, it's in there, started again. And Kaliko's here, but they won't enter. But just to avoid issues, I stayed back.
It's all right, don't just do anything stupid, okay? Who knows, this one might be a decent one.
I wish. D. It won't matter, it's a decent. Where? Sister, come, I'm here waiting for you. Be fast. Biko. Biko.
Mama, this is the girl I told you about.
You're welcome. Come on, Kakwa, you know I didn't see you very well inside. It was dark. No.
Thank you, Mama.
What is your name?
Ewoma.
That's not an Igbo name.
I'm from Iselukuma.
Across the Niger.
Delta Igbo.
Oh, Mbanuna. He crossed the river Niger, if I didn't have Igbo.
How old is that region?
Nah, it's not Igbo. You people are different. Chai, I said it, that the name is not Igbo.
Fana, ask so far, be a Itebeku Igbo.
Iselukuma is an Igbo.
Iselukuma
is an Igbo name.
Makalupu, they are not here. But then Isele is still okay. No. Right, very well. But I said it is not really an Igbo name. It's
a woman.
Okay, let me get you a wheelchair to sit down.
No. We want to take a stroll around the village. I want to show her around.
Oh, she wants to look around the Igbo village. Can you see how many an Opanakede?
Hello,
Igbo Konatana. Oh, Igbo Kobo.
Mom is funny. I told you she'll like you. Yes, you will. So let's go, so I'll show you around.
Okay.
I need to see the village square. Like I told you before, people don't run guard.
Are you out of your senses? Are you out of your mind? Eh? You did not see anybody to bring home. It is a girl from Delta. Who told you that Asaba women stay in marriage? Onyegwa.
How many times will I tell you that she's not from Asaba, that she's from Iseluku?
Iseluku din ebe. Ofufe ko una. Asaba Delta stay Iseluku. The same thing ko. A Delta girl will always be a Delta girl. If Ofufe ko, do you know what happened to you? When you marry her and bring her here now, or mother get three children. Before you know, she just take them away from you. To under man, you will not say again, you will lose. You don't know.
Oh.
Just tell me that he doesn't know all that.
Even if you to marry a Delta girl, for instance, let's just assume we're not agreeing. Or Bruno, that's mommy, what I get, that girl, not checking in the water. Want to marry? Eh? From the waters, are you blind? Can't you see?
How can you talk like this, Ezin? And when I see Namili Weja, does anybody come out of the waters? You were the ones who were on my neck to get married. I brought the first girl, you turned her down. I found someone I feel I will get married to and love and have a happy home. You still kick against it. What is it?
Kenya, you're not with your right sense.
Obviously.
No, forget. My enemies have gotten the best of me.
Mama, stop that nonsense. Happy being a cop. Nobody has gotten any best of me. I am with my right senses.
You are not. If you're in your right senses, you will not be sitting here spouting such nonsense with your mouth. You will not be sitting here spitting such nonsense with your mouth. You see that girl? She is leaving this house first thing tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
Okwamiya, Ekanechukwu,
if you don't know how to find the right woman to marry, we will help you. I have friends, as in good friends, whose sisters are ripe enough for marriage.
Yes.
Huh? And not all these things you are bringing home that we don't know where they came from. Only God knows how many hotel beds your backside have graced.
No. I will not sit here and have you insult a woman. She's a good girl from a good home.
Asi! A good home indeed. Can you explain a good home? Can you define a good home? She has brainwashed you and made from a good home. You believe that? You believe that? Hook, line, and sinker. Let me ask you a question, wait, Ekene. Do you know where Iseluku is? Across the night, you are going bound. In Akko.
Ezine, nobody invited you into my relationship.
Yeah.
Nobody has invited you into my relationship. If you do not want to see the wrong part of me, just keep your mouth shut. As for that girl, I will marry her and nothing will happen.
You are insulting me now, Koya. Sister, can you imagine? You are insulting me. Sister, can you know that we are here now trying to help you figure out your confused life? You never mean insult. Okwa Lugi, Tawan say. No, don't ask me now. It's not your fault.
All of you can go to hell.
Eh?
But if you're a woman, I will marry her.
Eh? Sister, don't bother yourself. Okay, woman. Let him go and marry a woman. I got me up. I want that woman and I tell woman to go take me up. Okay, woman.
Flow, flow, flow. Anyhow, she be living for me. Cause I like him so.
Hey, woman, what are you doing?
Please, I'm leaving. Come take me to the park.
You can't leave now, it's night.
I have to go. I mean, your mother and your sisters do not want me in this house. They don't want me.
They think I bewitched you.
They think I am from the water. They think that my people are evil and are bad. I mean, I cannot stay in the same house with the people who do not want me. No.
You can't listen to them.
I have to go.
Listen, you can't even go at this time. It's late. It's dangerous out there. What if something happens to you? How do I explain this?
Who cares? If something happens to me, fine. Please, I have to go.
No.
I don't even know why I have to follow you down to this place.
Please.
I don't know. Your sisters are cruel and bigoted. Who are there to judge somebody else? Who?
I'm sorry. Please don't do this. I'm the one who brought you. I love you. And I'm the one who takes the final decision here.
Please. Marriage involves families. I mean, how am I supposed to live happily with you if your family do not accept me? How? I need to go.
Hey, woman.
See, listen to me.
I have to go.
You can't go. Yes. Wait.
What kind of a thing is this? What kind of a family can man ban him inside like this? What is this?
A woman.
I had to come immediately to make sure you got home safe. And I'm really sorry about what my mother said to you concerning yourself and your family.
You don't have to apologize for them. You were not the one that said them.
But they had no right to judge you and your family like that.
Maybe they were right after all. I've heard people say such things about my people, but they think I am a murderer.
That's because you're beautiful.
Maybe they don't want you to get married to a beautiful woman. And maybe I will not make a good wife for you.
Can you cut with the maybes? I love you and I want you back. That's what matters. I'm the one who's getting married to you. Please come with me.
Your love comes with rejection and that I cannot handle. I mean, I have told my mother what happened and she said I should not see you again. I'm sorry. I think what I need to do now is just to take my time off, you know, to recover, and maybe someday you will find a woman that will love you and your family will accept.
What is all this? What kind of family am I from?
So that was how I broke up with a woman, and in that moment I met Nneka.
Nneka?
Yes, the second girl I wanted to marry.
No, you told me Iwoma was the second.
Actually Iwoma was the first. The one before her, we didn't have anything serious. Nneka was naturally a very good girl. Things were moving on smooth between us. But it didn't work out. It just stopped one day. The day I ran into a woman for the first time after we broke up.
You ran into her again?
Yes. And she was married.
To my prayers and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, here.
Yeah.
Here is a Kenya, my ex, the one I told you about.
The one whose mother and sister rejected you, right?
Yes.
They are lost. My game.
Mm-hmm. Ekene, meet my husband, Daniel.
Your what? You got married and you did not tell me?
Oh, I didn't think you would have wanted to know.
Well, thank you for leaving her for me. Mm-hmm. As you can see. The bitches, you mind?
Uh-huh.
We know. Right, excuse us, yes. Please.
Around badging into people.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Whatever the problem is, God is in control.
Excuse me, sorry. What's your name?
Why do you ask?
You seem like I've met you before.
I don't.
You are beautiful.
As beautiful as other girls you've dated.
Well, I've not dated so many girls, but more beautiful than all the girls I've dated. And the beautiful part of it is that you come from my place. We're from the same place, which means I wouldn't have to pay so much as bride price. And then, my people would not have any hesitation.
I think we should slow down. We just met. We should take our time and study each other properly to see if we'll make ourselves happy.
You're already making me happy.
A few rounds of exciting sex does not constitute happiness.
Yes, I agree.
Spend my whole life with you. You, oh, you, no one else will do. You, and only you. You're the answer to my prayers, and yes to the no says. And there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you.
You know it won't work, obviously, so.
Why won't it work?
For so many reasons. That Nneka girl is thoroughly a bad girl. She was into runs while we were in school. Nneka is a girl that dated all the governors and senators. She attended all the parties in Abuja. She is not the kind of girl you marry. Although not possible. And again, she's my friend.
Oh, good. Fine. Since she's your friend, it makes it easier. That means it will make her integrate into the family easily. And knowing that you know her from way back, she gets in, she becomes responsible, and everybody's at peace.
Really? You have not even come to terms with the main reason.
Which is?
She is not your mate. You cannot possibly marry a woman that is older than you.
And who told you she's older than me?
I am telling you because she's older than me. Otorom. Otoronge.
I knew you would always get something to hold on to. I knew you would always look for a reason not to accept her. There's always one reason or the other. But you know what? Fine. When I eventually find the woman I will settle down with, I will just invite you, Mama, and Sister Ada to the marriage. I'm not bringing anybody for you to peruse and assess again.
Perfect. Are you done? Kenne, I know what to do for you. I will help you as a sister. I will go and look for a very decent girl for you to marry. Nugo, case closed.
Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love could it flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love could it flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so.
So,
That's the story with my exes. So you know what you're coming into.
Why did you tell me?
I just felt you should know, normally, so you know what you're up against. My sisters are very uptight. In fact, they are involved in my life. They are interested in who I'm going to spend the rest of my life with. So if you're going to do this with me, you know we are in for a fight.
But you haven't asked me to marry you.
Yeah, but with the way things are going, it won't be long before we begin to talk towards that direction. It's okay, don't worry, let's go inside.
To my prayers and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my
Doc, how is your brother?
My brother?
Yes, the one that came the other day.
Oh, Ekene. Okay, it's fine. Why do you ask?
Nothing. Just that I've been thinking of him. I can't just get him off my head.
Really?
Yes.
Do you like him?
Yes, I like him. Who wouldn't like a man like that? He's a handsome man and I hear he's a banker.
Yes, he is.
Please help us tell him that he has admirers.
Is that so?
Yes.
Okay, I will tell him. You cannot go back to your work.
Okay, then.
Good afternoon. How are you? Who are you?
Are you Mr. Ekene?
Yes, I am.
Mama said I should give you this.
My mother?
Yes, sir.
What's inside?
Foodstuffs.
Wow. Mama, come in. Thank you very much. Come in. Mama has come again. She sent her with foodstuffs.
Good evening, Mama.
Good evening. Oh, okay. Mama wrote a letter. What's the meaning of this rubbish? Hello, Mama. What's the meaning of this? Did I tell you I was looking for anyone? Even if I was looking for a wife, is this this local village thing you brought here that I'm going to get married to? Mama, let this be the last time you will do anything like this, Biko. Biko.
Now chill and burn it down.
Just take a good look at the girl first before you start complaining.
Eh? I know what I'm doing.
I am telling you what I think right away. That girl is leaving my house right away. Now, now, now. It's not late. Okay? And don't do this again.
Now I'm your mother. Now I can't. And I know what is good for you.
I know the kind of girl that will take Exactly. The same way Mo naked is in the room. Yes, I know what I'm talking about. See, she's not like those city girls, eh? That you keep bringing home. You see those ones? They're after your money. The minute you lose your money, all of them, they will all leave you to your fate. But you see Esther, she's just like the Esther in the Bible. She will take good care of you. She will stand by you. Nina, don't lose this opportunity.
I'm repeating myself again. Don't ever try what just happened again. If you do, whatever happens to that person will be on your head. As for this girl, she's leaving my house right now. It's not late. And let me warn you, Mama. Do not send any other girl my way. This is the last time you do this because I will not even pay attention to that person. Okay, Danuya? Please. I'm old enough to choose who I want to settle down with. If I want to get married, I'll pick a wife and get married. And don't bother about me bringing her for you to see because I will not bring anybody for you to see and approve of again.
Okay, only again, Awa.
Bye bye.
Yeah, Antia. Yeah, bon. It has gotten to the point where Mama has to package a girl from the village and send to me.
I couldn't help but laugh. Anyway, I hope you are prepared.
For what?
Enough sex tonight. At least this one has your mother's seal of approval.
There's something wrong with you.
My own is that before you touch her, you have to satisfy me first. But wait a minute. Don't you think we should invite her over? I heard threesomes are mind-blowing.
Ulama, this is not a joke.
What do you want me to say? Okay, fine.
Jokes apart. The truth is,
I think your sisters and mom have good intentions for you, but they don't know how to express it. They are going about it the wrong way.
Just leave me alone. Is that too much to ask? They should stop interfering with my life. I'm capable of taking care of myself. I'm an adult.
I know you are an adult and I know you can handle this. But I really can't say much. Anyway, we have a little girl out there who is obviously confused about all this happening.
Who cares about her?
You don't know what your mother and her mom must have told her before she embarked on this journey. Who knows your wife to be? Anyway, please, I know she must be very hungry. Let me go and serve her. Let me serve her something to eat.
I know she must be very hungry.
Like I said, get ready. Hey!
What's your name?
Esther. My name is Esther.
Oh, Esther. Esther. I am sure you're hungry. Have you had something to eat?
No, nothing.
Okay. You'll have to come with me so that you can have your bath while I get you something to eat, okay?
Ah, no. Ma, just show me where the kitchen is. My mother said that when I get here, that I should cook for brother. I can prepare food for myself and for brother. Just show me the kitchen.
It's okay, but I don't think brother
would love you to prepare something for him now. Okay? First things first, you will have to have your bath. While I make you something to eat, then you sleep. By tomorrow morning, brother will give you something big to go back with. Okay?
Okay.
So what would you love to eat? Rice? Fufu?
What?
Come on.
Are you serious?
Yes.
And if he asks me to marry him now, I will.
No way, girl. You guys have known each other less than a month. No.
It's not just about the sex. I'm equally spending some quality time with him. You see, I have never met a man so tender, loving and caring. Right about now, my ex looks like a toad beside him. I don't know what I was thinking while dating that brute.
They say a girl has to kiss so many toads before meeting her Prince Charming.
And I have found mine. I'm sure he's on the verge of popping the question. The only thing hindering him now is fear.
Fear? Fear of what?
He told me that each time he takes a girl home, his sisters and mom reject the girl. He thinks the same will happen to us.
So what are you going to do about it?
Well, he told me that whenever he's ready to settle down, he will take just few of his friends to the girl's house to perform the traditional rites without informing his people. Whenever he's ready to do the white wedding, he will inform them.
That's the man I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I told you.
I mean, I'm in support of him. It's unbecoming of his sisters and mom, really.
Girl, you've got the right man.
Oh, yes.
I told you. Right man. I'm happy for you.
Thank you. So, how about that lecturer, sir? What?
That ugly looking man.
Oh, this ugly man.
I've got no time for that man.
I need to browse.
I have been talking to your sister, and she made me understand that you're not in any relationship for now.
Yes, I just came out of a traumatic relationship with this guy that I never knew he was a drug pusher. I'm just off men for now.
You should be thinking of settling down. Age piles up quickly, you know.
Yeah, I know, but what can I do? Men want just one thing from a woman, and when you refuse to give it to them, they think you're not serious. I'm just tired of relationships and affairs. I want to get married.
Precisely why I asked to see you. Can you remember my younger brother, Ekene? I'm sure you met him at my wedding.
Yes. The banker comedian. I remember, yeah.
You know him very well. You know he's my only brother.
Mm-hmm.
I do remember that during my wedding, you guys struck it off. I wonder why you didn't push through. Actually, both of you would have made a great couple.
I was deep in another relationship then. And I wouldn't have even considered him at that point in my life, so.
And now?
Now I'm free. I'm free now. And I mean, Ekene is a very nice guy. He will make a very great boyfriend.
Helen, I'm sorry, we're not talking about boyfriend, girlfriend relationships.
Okay.
My brother is ready to settle down. And we are so concerned with where girls swim around him.
I'm not surprised, you know. I mean, he's a very handsome guy.
Which is why we are trying to select a good woman for him. And I'm sure that both of you will build a fantastic family. You both have good jobs. You're beautiful people, very easy to people to fall in love with. Are you willing to give something a try with him?
My sister had already mentioned something like that to me. I'm aware of it.
Yeah, that's good. I am going to invite my brother over for dinner this Friday, and I would love you to be there. I want to reintroduce you to. Let's start something from there. What do you think?
I'll be there.
Sure?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So, how is Celine?
Oh, she's fine. She gives me a whole lot of trouble.
Helena, why?
The other day you asked me about my brother.
Yes, Doc.
Why?
Some of us are his fans.
Interesting. You really like him, don't you?
I like him. He has a good job. He's handsome. He's every woman's dream.
So why are you interested in him?
Doc, why are you asking me all these questions?
Can you just simply answer my question?
He looks like a responsible man. At my age, I need someone to call my own, my husband that I can take care of.
And you think you can make a good wife to my brother?
Yes, Doc. I believe that someone like that will have a woman in his life. And people like us can only hope and dream.
Okay.
Doc, but you haven't told me why you're asking all these questions.
Don't worry. When the time is right, I'll let you know.
Okay.
You can go back to your work now.
Ask me if I really meant what I said about admiring her brother.
So, what did you tell her?
You know I like him. I told her yes. But you know someone like that must have a girlfriend. I asked her why she was asking. She said she would get back to me. But do you think she's thinking about introducing me to her brother?
Well, I don't know. I'm not in her mind. Yes. And if I'm to say anything, I'll tell you not to get your heads all worked up. The guy in question is a banker, and not just a banker, a cute one as that.
I like him.
We both know this guy has a lot of girls running up and down around him. Yes. So I'm definitely sure Dr. Izine is not even thinking or saying anything close to what you were thinking.
So what should I do?
Anita, just get your heads off him and focus on your job.
We're not going the same way. I need to go to the market. I have to cook before he returns.
Come on, girl. This thing is becoming very serious.
I don't see that way. It's the normal thing girls do for their men. Besides, I have to do that, then return back to the house before my mother comes back.
Okay, well, soon Loma, my friend, has suddenly become someone's wife. And she has to go home to make food for her husband. But girlfriend, he has not asked you to marry him yet. Or has he paid your bride price? I know that Ekena is a good man, but she can only determine a good man when push comes to shove. and he remains steadfast. So, I do not want him to use and dump you just as your estate.
Not to worry. I'll be fine. Besides, Ekene says we're going out this evening. Has James told you yet?
Not yet, but you guys are quite fast.
Not to worry, he'll tell you. Bye, see ya.
Okay, good wife and make him.
Thank you.
There's something I want to tell you.
What is it?
That will have to hold on a while. I got a call from my sister. She wants me to come over to her place. And I'd like you to go with me. So just go get ready. Let's go there. Maybe when we're back, you make the food.
He wants me to go with you. What if she rejects me like she rejects the other girls?
There's no chance since I haven't proposed to you yet.
Yes, yet.
Yes.
Okay.
Alrighty, go get ready, eh? Yesterday no says and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I wanna spend my whole life with you. You know what else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers and yes to the no says and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. To my prayers and yes to the no says and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. You know what else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers and yes to the no says and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. To spend my whole life with you. You know what else will do. You and only you.
Oh. Hello, Auntie.
Hello.
Where are you now?
I'm about stepping out now.
Okay, see, you have to hurry up because he's already on his way. He'll be here any minute.
Oh, okay, I'll soon be there.
All right, love, I'm waiting.
To the no says and there's nothing
I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you.
Taxi!
Yes, I'm looking for something. No, I'm just coming. Oh no, what's your plan? I should die walking, isn't it? Please, I want to go and rest. I'm tired.
Good evening, ma.
Yes, Anita, how are you?
Fine, ma.
I got a night shift today.
Yes, ma.
When you close tomorrow morning, pass through my house.
Why, ma?
Because I want to go somewhere.
Where, ma?
Must you know everything? Good, come to my house. I will not kill you.
Okay. All
right? Fine. All right, girls. See you tomorrow.
Bye,
take care.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
What do you think we're going to?
How will I know?
Your father. Continue. Please arrange that for you.
Good evening. Who is she?
She's my girlfriend, Uloma. Meet my other sister.
It's my pleasure to meet you, ma'am.
Same here. You're welcome. Come in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Eken, what the hell do you think you're doing?
I don't understand.
I asked you to come for something very important. I didn't ask you to bring any sniff of a girl to my house.
Sister, please. I will take any kind of insult from you, but I will not have you insult me and my women again. I will go anywhere with anybody I please. I will marry whoever I want to. And there's nothing you, Mama, or Izine can do about it.
Low down your voice. There are people out there.
If you don't want me to shout, then do not insult me and my women. How would you feel if I called your husband a lousy fool?
You are out of your mind.
Maybe I should ask you that exact question.
Anyways, I made dinner for three people. I invited Helen over so that you both can meet. I didn't bargain for another person.
And who is Helen?
You remember Selena? My maid of honor at my wedding. She's our younger sister. I know that she will suit you perfectly. That's why I want you two to meet. Let's start something from here and end this blind search of a wife.
Sister, I'm not looking for a girlfriend. Neither am I looking for a wife. You see that woman out there? She's the one I want to marry. Thank you for your effort. But she's the one I want to get married to.
This woman has... Ekene, you will marry the woman we have appointed for you. It is for your own good.
It's a lie. It is for your selfish reasons. You're looking for someone you can control, someone you'll bark at and they'll shiver. Someone you will talk and she'll have her tails in between her legs. This one is not like that. You see that girl? She's fire. If you give it to her, she will give it to you. Thunder and brimstone.
Hey.
And you have to accept it.
Hey! We thought that those girls charmed you. Now I know better. You see this one? This is the one who has charmed you. How can you reject a girl from a wealthy home like Helen to something that dog vomited somewhere? Ijibuche.
I'd rather settle for a dog's vomit than endure your humiliation and insults anymore. You see that girl? She's the one I'm getting married to. And you must accept my decision. By the way, meanwhile, I hadn't proposed to her yet. I was waiting for the right time. But since it has come to this, I will do it tonight. In fact, right
now. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love could it flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so.
I heard your voice.
Yes, Consul.
There's no problem.
There's no issue. Yeah, I wanted to do this later tonight, but my sister just convinced me to do it now. Will you just do me the pleasure of being the mother of my kids? Be my wife, please. Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Boy.
Thank you.
What are you doing? Has madness come upon you? What the hell?
You don't know what you've just done. You will pay for this insult. I bet you.
You know what else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers.
Doc, yes. You haven't told me where we're going to. You told me you liked my brother, isn't it?
Yes, I like him.
And you want to settle down. Am I correct? Fine. I want to take you to my brother's house. And I want him to see you and let's see if he might be interested in you.
Huh, Jesus. You want to take me to your brother? And you didn't tell me about it.
Telling you about it? Why? What will happen?
I could have just gotten to the house freshen up. You know, I'm just coming back from work and I look terrible.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you do look terrible. But I think it's the best. Because my brother, if he sees you like this, mm-hmm. and he gets to know that you're just coming out from work, looking this beautiful, I'm telling you, he'll just approve of you. He loves hardworking women. Hmm? So don't worry about that.
Oh God, but I'm feeling nervous. So you're actually going to introduce me to your brother? Hey Agam, I can't believe this.
What can't you believe?
I'm just surprised.
You want to settle down?
Yes.
My brother needs a wife, and I think you'll make a good wife for him.
But I don't think I'm that kind of girl that he would like.
Who says that? It's just a normal human being, a normal boy, like every other person. So it's, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. All right?
I don't know if he would like.
Don't worry.
Why didn't you ask her yourself?
What did you say? That girl opened that gutter she called a mouth and was telling me that she's your wife. Excuse me?
Do you have any problem with that?
I don't understand you. Where and when did you see that one? That you have given her a ring already.
Soon she'll be my wife, like you already know. The earlier you accept that, the better for everybody.
Ekene, that is a very big lie. You lie. Oh, Ekene, so you want to make a fool of everybody in the family, isn't it?
Well, don't worry. Sister Mama must hear this.
You can go ahead and call Mama. And tell her. As for Sister, she knows already. Things are right in front of Sister in her house. So you can go ahead and tell Mama what you want to tell her, because it's a settled case already.
You are joking, Ekene. You are joking. You are a joker.
You're all invited. Next week I'm going to see her people. So tell Mama.
Liar. What are you still doing here? Is this your house? Come and stand up. Move.
Bye, Felicia. I hope she did not do anything funny in there.
No, she didn't.
I am in for a serious business.
Never seen this kind of people before.
Sister, can you imagine? Ekene was telling me that he's going to the girl's parents' place by next week to ask them for the traditional marriage rites, procedures, and all those nonsense. Can you imagine?
Isn't it? It's either that boy is going mad, or whichever charm that girl is using on him is very strong. I mean, strong indeed. Because this is not the Ekene we used to know. This one is a total stranger. When you have break, Ekene.
Sister, Ngebwezokubuna, we have to stop him and stop him real fast.
If not, he will go and marry that girl. That girl, Ebosi, Amarokwa. We don't know where she's from.
Isn't it the most annoying part? This thing happened here in my sitting, right before me. And the poor girl I had arranged for him, you know who that is? Helen, my maid of honor, younger sister.
Helen, that beautiful girl?
Isn't it, you can imagine? Isn't it, I had spoken to this girl about Ekene, and she was willing to give him a chance. Just imagine marrying into that family. They are wealthy. They have everything. Have you forgotten that their father was once a minister?
I know.
But the idiot I called brother proposed to the she monkey she brought to my house.
Oh no.
Ekene just, fear Kananya Temule. He put shame on me.
Sister, do you know that? I even called Mama and I told her what happened. She now said that she sent Ekene a girl. Ekene practically chased her out from his house. Can you beat that?
Isn't it? I think I've had enough. I am going to carry Mama tomorrow morning to the city. I want Ekene to look at all of this in the face and tell us where this madness is coming from. I want to see where he will get that courage to face us. And by tomorrow morning, if that girl is still in that house, hey, I will so deal with her that she will not forget me in a hurry.
Believe me.
Sister, you've never heard half of it. Do you know that she was telling me and she's a Kenneth's wife? And she was saying that wearing a Kenneth's boxers and shirt, can you beat that?
What do you blame? You don't need to blame the girl. Is it Kenneth that you will blame? He's the cause of all this insolence. Oh, you boxers, not singlet. And she was telling you that she's a Kenneth's wife.
That girl has guts.
You like them?
Yeah, they're colorful. Mm-hmm.
Flower base inspired.
Oh, really?
Can't you see the flowers?
Yeah, different colors.
She knew this, she knew that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she. She be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so.
I like him so.
How a love could it flow, flow, flow. Anyhow, she be living for me, cause I like him so.
I like him so. I like him so.
They're here in full squad. Now, remember. We have a battle, but you have to stay strong. We'll get over this, okay? Don't fret.
It is you I should be worried about. Not me. Baby, trust me. I can hold my own.
You and only you.
That's my baby. No, yeah. She says, okay. To the no sense and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. You know what else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers. And yes to the no sense and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life. To my prayers and yes to the no sense and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. Am I not talking? These are your faces are like this. Did anybody die?
It is obvious that you do not recognize that there is somebody standing right in front of you.
I can see you have a habit of invading into people's privacy. And that I do not like. By the way, who invited you into this bedroom?
Get up. Go pack your things. It is high time you left this house.
I hate people who overstep their boundaries. And right about now, that is what you're doing. Touch me again and I'll beat you blue black.
What did you say? I didn't hear you. What did you say?
What is going on here?
I hate to repeat myself, but for the sake of clarity, and so nobody will blame me for what I'm about to do, I said if you touch me again, I will beat you blue black.
And I'm touching you, stand up!
Touch me again! Touch me again! Will you touch me again?
Is it that you're carrying bottle for? Eh? You're holding bottle for isn't it?
I told her not to touch me again. And she went ahead to slap me on my leg. And who invited you people into this bedroom?
Excuse me?
The last I remember, you are not paying for this house. So why are you here? Why are you here? Whatever I do in my husband's house is none of your businesses. Wait. I'm sure the person I'm in his bedroom doesn't mind.
Chelo, you open that drainage you call a mouth and talk to me like that. Do you know who you are talking to? Emmanuel. Do you know?
And like I said earlier, I am not in the habit of repeating myself.
Sister, the young woman has made herself clear. Leave her room.
Boy, I got that you're here. Are you supporting this girl over your sister?
This is the girl I'm going to spend the rest of my life with, not you. Okay?
She has said, and I am saying, leave this room. Have I ever come to your houses to barge into your rooms? Or have I ever chased anybody out of your houses?
I don't understand.
What's the meaning of this? Do you know you're trespassing?
Boy,
We are trespassing.
Yes.
And she said you should leave! Leave!
Okay, we're leaving.
He said you should leave! Leave,
yes!
We're
going.
Leave! Please have a
seat. Oh my God! I never knew they could be this scared!
She was shaking.
Shivering.
Your elder sister was also shaking.
I was like, is that sister Ada? And you acted so rough. I was almost scared myself at some point.
I didn't even believe it myself.
Oh my God. Oh my God. This life.
Where did you even get these things? Where did you get them from?
It was necessary. I had to source for this. It was necessary to put them in their place.
I just acted like one rat girl.
I was like, hey.
Kenne, I want to ask you, why do you want to kill me? Why do you want to kill your mother, Ichibum? Or Gene?
Mama, I have not told you I want to kill you. I have no such plans, so I don't want to kill you. But if you have decided to die, the only thing I owe you is a befitting burial.
How long will you shut up? You looking for one? Boy, I said you should shut up. What is wrong with you? You disgraced me in my own house because of that girl. Mama here brought a girl from the village. You threw the girl out of your house. Ezine brought another person. You walked Ezine out of your house. What has come over you? I ask you, boy, who and what do you think you are? All we are trying is to fix your life for you and you are here misbehaving. Huh? When will you get senses into your brain?
What do you think I am? 17? Or you think I'm a toddler that you toss around at will? Is that it? You want to take decisions over my life for me? Listen, let me tell you, I won't have you do this to me. I am old enough to take my decisions. That's why a reputable bank found me worthy to head a department in that bank. Henceforth, I will not have anything to do with any decision you take. I will decide who I live with, who I stay with, and how I run my life. I allowed you meddle in my affairs before because I wasn't ready to start a family. But now that I'm ready to build a home, I will not have you dictate to me how to live. Ada, did I choose your husband for you? Did I? And you, Ezine? I wasn't there when you met that idiot you were dating. That lousy drunkard that you kept and feed. A man that's not even responsible for himself. And you sit here and talk to me about sense of judgment? Really? Don't try it again. And let me warn all of you. Let this be the last time you bring any girl my way. I'm not here to sample girls. Girls are not commodities. They're not groceries. You walk into a supermarket and pick. I have found a woman I want to marry, and she's the one I'm going to spend the rest of my life with. If you don't like it, all of you can bloody well go to hell.
Oh, is that why you started traditional marriage proceedings without consulting anybody? It is an abomination.
Oh, sorry, Ibia. If you like, you attend. If you don't, you sit your butts out back in that house. There is no way it is written anywhere in any law that I have to go for my traditional marriage with my mother and sister. What a bed
there. Hey! Ekene, you are a fool! You are a very huge fool.
What is it? Ezine, if you open your mouth and call me a fool in my house, I swear to God, I will slap you. You will not know what hit you.
And I am saying to you again that you are a fool. You are a big fool! Hey! I'm a boy! Boy, what have you done? What have you done? You raised your hand and slapped your elder sister?
And I will slap anybody who raises her voice to call me a fool in my house. What is wrong with all of you? And when any moon needs see, don't you have sense? Can you not see you're driving me nuts? What the fuck is wrong with you? If anybody does it again, go to the other side of me.
Oh, Itogo, you've grown. After learning 2, 3, 4 letter words, you have arrived. Okuiche! Huh? Ezine was right. Ekenechukwu, you're a big fool.
Sister Abokoname, a fool. Abokoname, a fool again. Get out of my house, all of you.
Eh?
Get out of my house!
Eh? Nap! You are sending your mother out of your house.
If you don't get out of this house, I will throw you out of this house. Get out of my house!
Mama, calm down. Mama,
relax.
It's him now. Oh, got your pocket.
Get out of my house! Come back here.
Also, go, I'm going. Everything
is fine. I'm going to be able to do this. I'm going to be able to do this. I'm going to be able to do this. Out!
I can survive.
You think you can survive without me?
I will survive without you.
Really?
Boy, I give you 2 weeks. I give you 2 weeks to come running back to us. I get bet.
If you see me coming back to you, then know it's sand. I just did it. If I have to get out of my house.
Really?
Out! Diala, let me see you here, you hit shots. You think I'll let you run my life for me? Dumb fox.
She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she be my one and only, my super baby. She did this how, she did that how, but I cannot leave her now. You better mind yourself, now my baby be that to you. I like him so.
Okay, Nene. Why am I doing one of my DJ? Are you mad?
Flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so. How a love could it flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so.
I like him so.
Never been that angry before.
It's all right. Once in a while, you let the steam off.
I mean, through the years, they have run my life for me. They tell me what to do, what to eat, what to wear, where to go, who to see, who not to see. I've never been given an opportunity to take any decision for myself. It's as though I'm a vegetable. I can't do anything. I'm not capable of handling my own affairs. No, I'm a full-grown man. I should be allowed to do things myself. If it fails, then it becomes my business.
It's okay. Calm down. At least you've told them all, so it's fine.
You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers. And yes to the no says. And there's nothing I won't do to be beside
you. On purple or belief, eh? There's no kind of insult you did not give on us.
The girl he said he wants to marry broke a bottle and threatened to stab Ezine and I. Josiano, is that not what we're talking about? Eh?
Uncle Gwa Josiano, the kind of girl that will break a bottle and threaten a fellow man. Eh? Is she not a club girl? Is it not in the club that you pick such girls? Tune Kenya.
That's not the only thing. Do you know that Kenya slapped Ezine? Left, right, and center. He wanted to dislocate her job. Oh, beautiful, my former was thunderous.
Again, I slapped his in this.
Nah, I couldn't believe it. Can you imagine that Again walked us out of his house and threatened to cut, in short, he cut us off? Why? Because we tried to advise him on the kind of girl to marry. Only fed in Jonia. In this land, before a man marries a woman, Ndibefa will go and investigate the woman's background to be sure she's good enough for her. Ekene is getting married. Did he tell you anything? As the head of the family, Onwefe, about you, Wale?
I've heard you. I will call Ekene Chukwu and find out where all this is coming from. You push your stake, come. I'll talk to him.
We're all women. We're all women and we're bothered. And actually, we don't want our name to be lost. Because if anything happens to Ekene, as the only child, a boy, front and
support. God forbid. Nothing will happen to him. I'll talk to him.
Please. Nam, please talk to him because he's the only son. If we look for Ekene and we don't find him, we're finished. You know, the girls of these days, you know how they are. Hey! All these girls he brings around, all they want to do is marry Ekene. They're after his money. They will marry him, then they will kill him and take over everything.
God will never allow it to happen.
Then better talk to him.
No,
talk to him more.
I will.
Uncle, please. You need to be fast about this. Kekene a lead you on my answer.
Hi!
Allo. Allo.
Eh? Allo. And you do a lie. That kind of slap.
I don't know what is wrong with boy. I'm gonna be finna me.
Ekene slapped his in the
honestly.
Left, right, and center.
Mama.
And center, in short, he had cut all of us off because of a woman.
Hello?
Ekene Chukwu? It is me, Mbakwe.
Whoa.
Uncle Mbakwe, greetings. I was even meaning to call you.
Since you don't want to remember us, we decided to remember you now.
Yeah, I was going to call you really because I want to come over to the village. It's very important.
Bam! That means we are thinking along the same lines. Because I was actually planning to call you to come and see me. But now that you called, please, I want to see you.
Fine, I already have plans of coming to see you, Uncle.
Please, don't fail. It is important you come.
I will. Sure will. Mama, is that the way to welcome somebody to your house?
Mind your business. I wasn't talking to you. By the way, why did you bring her to this compound? After all she did to us.
We came to see you and for her to know this place and for us to see Uncle Mbakwe. So we can start talking about the marriage.
Please, you, a boy in Dewa, you threw me out of your house. Okay? What are you doing here? What are you doing in my own house? Biko, leave.
Point of correction. This house is my father's house. And as the only son, it is more of my house than it is yours.
Do you know who built the house?
Kabasali. Send Namkob.
Please, take this woman out of this compound. After the way you treated us, you cut my daughters and I off because of this woman. Okay? Biko, get out of my compound.
Can't be able to go that way, I have a barrette.
I am not interested. Kifina Metuliaka, don't calm him down. He's my son. I can argue with him. He's none of your business. Yes! And as I'm talking, you're doing eye like that. Rubbish! Because see, look, you people get out of my compound. Carry your motor and leave.
It's not about ice.
I'm not interested. Inuge, I'm not interested.
Come. I hope you don't take these things to heart. I know Mama, she's my mother. Just don't worry. She might go on with this initially, but eventually she has no choice but to accept you.
Darling, your wife is strong at heart. Listen, I made up my mind to marry you the very first day you told me all about what Mama and your sisters have been doing to the ladies you bring. So, I am ready. I came prepared. There's nothing to worry about.
Carry your car and go.
Mama,
carry your car out of my
house.
I'm gonna go get my mom.
Uncle Mbakwe.
Yeah.
Good evening.
Unike. You have come, eh?
Yes, I just came now. I went to the house to see Mama, then decided to. I was on my way to your place.
Oh, I see.
It's part of the reason that I've come.
Yeah. Okay, is that something we'll stand on the road and discuss? Let's get inside.
Okay, Uncle, better. No, take him a one.
Uncle, that way.
Uncle, you know how people say that when a man is old enough, he needs a woman by his side as a companion. And he who finds a wife, he says, has found a good thing. So I have come today with Uloma, the girl I want to marry, to introduce her to you and the family.
You found a very beautiful woman.
Thank you, Uncle.
And you also, you did the right thing by bringing her to me.
Thank you, Uncle.
Good. Now, how are you?
Very well, sir.
Good. You are welcome in my house.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
From Olu.
Olu?
Yes, sir.
Olu. I know Olu so well. I'm Olu Afumani. Olu. Who is your father?
Dr. Uzodinma Ibe, sir.
Dr. Uzodinma Ibe? Yeah. It's a very small world. Dr. Uzodinma Ibe. She's a very good friend of mine.
Uncle, are you serious?
We were schoolmates. We were together at Hope Waddell. He's a very good man.
Hope Waddell, Calabar?
I'm telling you. Whoa. My daughter, you are welcome to my house.
Thank you so much, sir. That's true. Wow. Yes.
But I heard you broke a bottle for your mother-in-law and your sisters-in-law. Where did you learn that from?
Uncle, we were just acting. Ekena and I discussed that before I carried out that act. He had told me that they would stand against us. So I did it just to make them know that we are serious. Yes, sir.
Which is part of the reason I came. Uncle, you know the number of women I've brought home that they have rejected. You were the one I always came to for complaint.
You don't have to say much. Your mother and your sister that came here to complain how you slapped his neck and chased them out of the house and said that you cut off the links, any link with them. And above all, that you go for your traditional marriage without inviting them. Is that true?
Uncle, there was no way I would do that. Okay? I slapped Izine because she first tried to drag Ulam out of the house. Out of my house. Because they didn't want me to marry her. Upon that, she called me a fool. Irrespective of anything, I am a man and I will have no woman call me a fool in my own house.
You've spoken like a man.
Yes, Uncle. And come next week, Saturday, we are intending to go see her people. That's part of the reason I came to see you. There's no way I'll go on that kind of journey without you and my family. I need Ezine, I need Ada, I need my mother. I want you to help me talk with them. Let us make peace. Because I've decided Uloma is the one I'm getting married to, whether they like it or not. And she has to be part of this family. So just talk to them, let's make peace, and let peace reign in this family. Or we'll try him natural.
There must be peace. And I will speak with your mother.
Thank you, Uncle.
Thank you, Uncle.
You are welcome. You are welcome.
You might not have agreed with the choices he made before. But this time, I think Ekene has made the right choice. Uloma here is the daughter of my very good friend and schoolmate, Dr. Uzodinma Ibe from Olu. Anybody that comes from Ibe's lineage must be a good person.
And I believe Ulama here is a good girl also. As for what happened in the past between you, your daughter and Ekene, let me say that Ekene is trying to assert himself as a man. Oh yes. And the right to choose someone he will live and spend the rest of his life with is solely his. So let us keep the sword and allow peace to reign in this family, please. Bikono, Bikono.
Mama, I am sorry that coming into Ekene's life has brought you so much pain. I love Ekene. I love him with all my heart. He's the best thing that's happened to me in my entire life. I am compelled to love anyone who is associated with him too. Because I cannot say I love him and not love his mother and his elder sisters. I promise to be a good wife to him and a good daughter-in-law too.
You promise?
I promise. I promise, Mama.
Yes, Mama. Please, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mama. You are my mother.
Shame.
I have no mother. Isn't there an Adakwa, my sisters? I have no other sisters. And if you want me to be that only son who will make this family proud, all I am begging is for you to support me to marry Uloma. She's a good girl. That way we will have peace.
And Mama, I promise I will never raise a bottle again, for it is not who I am.
You promise?
I promise.
Oh, my kiko, Mama.
Oh, man, call the bottle. Mama, and you must come for my wedding, no?
Boy, man,
mood. You see that slap you gave me that day? You will pay heavily.
Name your price and I will pay.
Please, please, please. Don't allow me to pick another bottle here. Don't let me pick another bottle here.
Okay. When you broke that bottle, I thought Ezine here was already dead.
I can imagine her face.
When I did that, I thought I had cut myself. Huh. I've seen some bad boys do it before, you know, on TV, and I had to follow suit.
You did it so well that I thought you were an expert.
Really?
I tell you, once you graduate, you join Nollywood. You will make an excellent actor.
That's also, I know so.
Yeah, this boy.
What?
You don't have respect.
For?
Oh, yeah, you. Come. Oh, yeah. Come, let's go to the kitchen.
This girl is
This boy called my husband has finished all the cooked food in my house. I don't have anything to feed my husband.
Sister, I don't know why he's been eating.
He's eating too much.
He's eating too much.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Isabel, what? There's this friend of mine, very handsome. He said he's looking for a medical doctor to marry. Should I introduce him to you?
I hope it's not like him.
Don't even mention that name when we are talking about prospect.
I didn't really think any name to win.
I'm not there.
But you people showed me pepe. Oh. You people really showed me pepe.
But your big sister, so we are protecting you. We were protecting you.
Yeah, I hear you.
Nina, eh? You're tired from washing. Why don't you leave these things? When your wife comes back, she will wash the clothes for you.
Mama. Pity the young girl now. You know when she's done helping me with chores in this house, she'll still have to go to her mother to help her too.
Her mother? Talking about her mother, when do we get to see her? You know, we really need to hurry up, oh, because I want to bring this girl in. Eh? Oh, what? Okay, Nasozi, why are you laughing? Well,
Mama? I remember how you fought me because of Uloma. Now you cannot wait to have her in your house.
That was then now. Onamada had an amazing mistake. It was a mistake. You see, you only get to know people when you bring them close to you. Then you get to know that they are good. She's a beautiful and fine girl and I like her.
You're right, Mama. That's true.
So, when are we going to see her people?
Soon. I initially planned for us to go this weekend, but the father is not in the country. He traveled to the UK. He'll be back next week, so we put it for next week, Saturday. Yes.
So have you finished all the arrangements? Is there anything we can help you with?
There's nothing you can help me do, Zoike. Everything that needs to be done has been done. Most especially, we have told our uncles in the village to get ready. That's what matters to me. So come next week, Saturday.
Hey, I can't wait. I cannot wait.
You cannot wait for me to get married or for you to have Loma's daughter-in-law.
Father, but now, is it not the same thing?
Man, I give one Yesika. If he mellow, man.
If that's the kind of woman I wanted for you.
I'm happy that finally you have liked Loma. My favorite.
Before, it's just that the likeness has increased. I like all of them. It's just condition.
Mama, we're going to see you fan we go to Nankwa because I had the mumba.
Where?
This Saturday. The father is coming in, so we scheduled for on Saturday.
You know what?
What?
When I look at you, I marvel.
You marvel? Why?
Do you remember the night we introduced Uloma to you? And how you refused to go out. And look at how fast everything has progressed. Yes. Here I am seated. Talking about accompanying you to her parents' house to commence marriage proceedings. I mean, everything is fast-paced. This is what I call a whirlwind romance.
A whirlwind? Come off it, bro. We've not for 3 months, he and I.
Precisely. Which man dates a woman for 3 months and decides to marry her?
Hey, I've seen shorter liaisons, okay? I mean, then what's the point anyways? I thought about it. We're compatible. Mm-hmm. I love her so much, she does same, so why wait?
You know, I must tell you the truth. There was only one thing on my mind when I decided to do what I did. And that was to getting a girl who will help you surmount all your problems until you're able to get one, I mean a decent one you can marry.
That must be the joke of a century. Who else can be more appropriate than a woman who makes my heart beat fast? The sound of her voice sends shivers down my spine. Each time I think about her, I just see myself walking down the aisle with her arms in mine.
Come back. Come back from Wonderland before you get a sack.
Not to worry. I'll stop on Saturday.
Oh my God.
Thanks, man, for that intro.
You're welcome.
Wow.
Woo!
Let me see your visible next year again. Pastor, you go deep in opportunity. What are you still doing here?
What are you still doing here? Now pick those up, miserable gogoro, whatever you call it, and leave now. You don't want to leave, eh?
Wait for me. I'm coming. Please
calm down, please.
What do you mean by calm down? Go and tell those people there. I don't want to see those gold digging opportunities in my house. Go and tell them to leave. If not, I will do something that I will regret, and you will regret also. Tell them to leave.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I cannot wait for me.
Are you still sitting here?
I cannot.
Oftentimes I wonder how to go about.
That's not funny at all. Oh. Yeah, hello, Uloma, what's up, babe? What? Can your father do a thing like that? Really? Oh, hello, babe. Babe.
Is there anything the matter?
Yes. Uloma just called me now to tell me that Ekene and his people came to our house for the traditional marriage introduction. And her father refused them.
Why?
I don't know. I think I have to see her. Okay?
Hello? Ekene? What is this I'm hearing? What do we call that? Class consciousness or what? Rubbish.
I think at this point we owe some people an apology.
Chelokwa, did we offend Dr. Ude?
I mean, why should we apologize to him?
I am not talking about Dr. Ibe. I am talking about those girls you and your daughters rejected when Ekene brought them.
I was not the only one that rejected them. It's called family rejection.
Our family did not reject anybody. It was you and your daughters.
Okay, so which way forward now?
The way forward is that we should call that over again and apologize to her. She has a strong spirit.
Strong spirit indeed.
Well, let me start going, since you don't want to accept my suggestion.
But he has not said no.
I understand English.
What I do not understand is the statement that he is compelled to say no. What does that mean? Is he going to marry his daughter? He's spoken highly of me, which means he likes me. I understand the exam part. I, for one, will not have my daughter compromise her exams on account of marriage.
So, who or what is compelling him to say no?
Well, I am of the opinion that you've taken this matter to heart. And I don't think it's necessary. Insofar as I'm concerned, the man is bothered about his wealth. He told you that Uloma is his only child and his heir. He's only concerned about who he will bequeath his wealth to. And whoever marries Uloma gets everything he has worked for.
In other words, he's suspecting me to be a gold digger?
I don't want to put it in those words.
For Christ's sake, I'm a working class man. I'm a banker. I work hard for my money. What does he have that he thinks I cannot work hard to make? All I want is just to love his daughter and marry her. That is it. I'm not after his wealth.
He doesn't say it that way, does he?
If that's how he sees it, then nobody will marry the girl.
It has to be someone with a deep pocket.
That's rubbish. I mean, that's balderdash. Is it actually about money or a man she'll be happy spending the rest of her life with? Is that it?
I tell you something, Ekene. Without money, there is no happiness.
Actually, I'm not enamored about this Yemi guy. Not that I have anything against Yoruba guys, but you know how they are. Like Ekene pointed out the other time. This guy is dependent on you. You are the one paying all the bills. Isn't it? Can't you see that this guy doesn't have anything tangible doing for a living? Are you willing to cope with all that?
Sister, I am 32 years old.
In the next few years,
I'll be an old maid hanging on the shelf. Fine, Yemi is a Yoruba boy. Yeah, I don't have anything with that, anything wrong about that. I'm cool. If I am not appreciated here, let me go to where people love me. Sister, sincerely,
I don't have any issue with him being Yoruba guy. He's a Nigerian, and that is cool.
What does he do?
He's into government contracts. I know that the few ones he's been doing has not been yielding positive results. But I know that he has done some in the past, and of course I believe they will yield fruit positively, even if they do not. He's from a rich family, the only son. And peradventure, the father will die soon, and then he's going to inherit all the property. Even if he does not inherit the property, I do not care. Sincerely, I am not after his money. I am a medical doctor, and I earn good income. We can live on that.
Isn't it? That is not good enough. You don't get married on speculations. What if anything happens to your practice tomorrow? What if his father refuses to die? And what if government contracts dry up? Can't you see there are many ifs?
Sister, I want to get married. You are in your home with your children. I want to have mine too. Yes. This is the first time in a long while someone asked me to marry him and meant it. So this one, I'm not letting it go.
Since it seems like you've made up your mind, I can't stand against you.
Thank you.
What is bothering me most now is about Ekene's issue. I don't know how to go about it.
There is no issue there.
What do you mean?
Yes, because that man will say yes. Obviously. That is every woman's dream. Yeah, I heard about that man in medical school that is a very tough man. But my brother is every man's dream for his daughter. That one is solid, it's not an issue. There's nothing there to worry about. Yeah.
No, no, no stress attached.
Uloma, Uloma, you just abandoned your breakfast.
Hey, young woman.
Good morning, Doctor.
Where are you going again? Huh? Do you still live in this house or you've turned it to a stopover motel for you?
I don't understand, Daddy.
You don't understand? You don't understand? You think I'm blind? You think I don't see? Eh? You leave very early and return very late? That is if you care to return at all. Eh? You jump around with that young man who came here to inquire about you the other time. Look, let me tell you. That man is not your husband. And he will never be. Oh yes. Look, when you are ready to marry, we will look for a man with the same pedigree with you. Yes. So if I were you, I will start breaking the link that bonds two of you together. Because that's the right thing to do.
Yeah, but my love.
Just shut up. Did I ask for your opinion?
I'm just trying to.
You're trying to do what? I don't want to hear from you. Look at you. You can't even give me a son. Yes. Now that I have a daughter that I will give her to somebody that can be my heir, you are here interfering.
Nonsense.
Did you hear that? Did you hear what Dr. Chuk said to me? Because of you. Oh, God.
Answer to my prayers, and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you.
Dembakwe, good evening, sir.
Hi. Praise.
Sir.
Is this you?
It's me. You're not looking bad at all.
Who? Nema. I was talking about you today. That we owe you an apology.
Oh, Dey. You don't owe me an apology. See, Dey, I've learned that God is the only one that can give one true happiness. A man can give you the happiness.
Yes.
So you don't owe me an apology.
Oh.
Only God that can give one true happiness. Dey, I almost died of heartbreak.
No. Ekene cannot do a thing like that. Eh? Did you in any way engage in a fight with him?
No, Uncle. I'm just coming from his mother's house now. She just confirmed that she and her daughters do not want me to get married to their son.
They did not mention that to me. Chikene just came here to tell me that, to tell me about your marriage proposal he had with you and the possible marriage rights.
Uncle, maybe they are right. Maybe I'm not good enough for him. What crime did I commit? Because I'm from Owerri. Is it because I'm from Owerri, Uncle?
I'm sorry about that. Eh? I'm sorry about that. I will invite Ekene so I can talk with him. But just know that sometimes bad thing happens for good things to prevail.
Eh? Wipe your tears, huh? It's okay. It's all right, don't it? It's okay.
Dey, Now I believe what you told me back then. That sometimes bad things happen for good things to come. And indeed.
It is evident.
Yes. I'll come to your house later to give you my invitation.
Ah! Oh, you are married?
Yeah. Actually, it's my white wedding. I'm true with my traditional wedding.
Hey. Congratulations, Neo.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Very much. Thank you.
Now.
Thank you. Yeah, take care of yourself.
I like him so. How I love could it flow. Anyhow, she be living for me. Cause I like him so. How I love could it flow. Anyhow, she be living for me. Cause I like him so.
Do you know what he told me this morning? That when it's time for me to get married, he will give me someone from the same pedigree.
What kind of nonsense is that? Like, seriously? So, what did he say to you? Did you agree to all that?
He thinks he's the only one who can sound like a dictator. He hasn't seen stubbornness yet. I will marry who I want. And if he refuses, I will run away with her career.
Babe, you are right, it's your life, but so, what's this man's problem?
I don't know, in all honesty, I don't know. I have no clue his problem with Ekene. But I will ask my mom to beg on my behalf. And if he refuses, then he should get ready for the biggest fight he's ever experienced in his life. I will marry who gives me happiness, not one stuffed up idiot he would manufacture from his clique of wealthy fools.
Babe, it hasn't gotten to fight, but anyways, it's your life. Babes, you have bad mouth though. Don't tell me you're learning from me.
I haven't even started yet. I'm so pissed off. I'm really angry. Anyway, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Because I cannot call me that his car is stopped somewhere. Mm. If it's faulty. So I have to pick him up and take him to his office. Okay,
let me take all right, him. Bye.
Mama, I came to thank you and your family especially because if I had married Ekene, I wouldn't have been where I am today. I just want to say thank you very much.
You know, I tried though. Honestly, I tried to tell Ekene to marry you, but you know how men are.
I
told him that someone that can take care of a hotel can actually take care of a home. Mama.
It's okay, Mama. Mama, here. This is my wedding invitation. And Mama, I will be so glad if you would honor this invitation. Please. Don't worry. I will send my driver to come and pick you.
I thought it's your brother.
No. That's not my brother. That's my driver.
Hey.
And he will come and pick you, not with this.
With another?
Yes.
Hi. Is it from the hotel?
No. Mama, I'll be on my way now.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Mama, take care of yourself.
I will.
Thank you. Bye. See you.
Okay, see you. Do you still work at the hotel?
No, Mama.
Yeah. I work for American. I want this girl with a future. I work for American and I want a future. Just because I complained once.
Baby, listen, baby, I have made my decision. And nothing can change that. Listen. When I get home, I will talk to my mother to speak with my dad about this. I believe she's going to have him change his mind.
Maybe that won't be necessary.
Why do you say that? Or what do you mean?
What's the use? He's your father. He has made his decision. I don't think there's anything anybody can do to make him change that. So why fight?
It is my life, not his. I am the one who is caught in the middle. When he chose to marry my mother, did anyone stand in his way? Why does he want to wreck my happiness?
He has said that we are not from the same class. Maybe he's right. Maybe you should look for someone of the same societal stratum as you.
Oh, please, Ekene. I do not care about social standings or background. Darling, you are my life. You're my everything. It is you that I love. And no one can change that. If my father refuses to allow us to get married, I will abscond with you.
You're not serious.
I am ready to run away with you.
Nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. You
know what else will do. My mother is so unfair. What is doing to me? To cut my inheritance if I marry you.
Yemi, I do not think he's serious. It's just a threat. I feel he wants to test your faith to see whether you're serious or not. Eh? He can't do that.
Baby, yeah, you don't know my father. My father is the most wicked person I've ever seen in this world. He would do exactly what he has said.
Is that why you're crying? I don't get it. Okay, if your father cuts you off, can't you fend for yourself and stand on your own?
Baby. See, you don't know how long I've waited for this inheritance. And if my father is as wealthy as he is, then I don't have to work all my life. Yes.
Do you know that my father is the chairman of many companies in this country? And I will now lose all my inheritance because of you.
You don't know how painful.
No. You cannot be serious. You must be ridiculous. I want to understand. Do you mean to tell me that all this while you've not been planning for yourself? You're waiting for your father to die first so you can inherit all his money? Are you serious?
Maybe me. It is my right. What I will do now is I will go and plead with my mother, and she's the only one that can change his mind. Because this money must not pass me by. It must not pass me by.
Fine. I think we can do that first. For you to sit down here and start crying like a child, just go and talk to your mother. I think that is better. So we can solve this whole thing.
Please, baby, pray for me so that when my mother talks to him, he will give me my inheritance. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Oshun. Money for help.
She was here. She was here to brag about her oil company husband. Eh? Mommy made a mistake. Should have called me earlier before now. Let me push her out of this compound.
You would have pushed her out?
Yes. I will tell her that she's not the only one whose husband works in an oil company.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking now?
Mama, what are you thinking?
About Ezine. You know she's not happy. In short, I'm just thinking of what Maze Mbakwe said the other day.
And what was that?
That, you know, we've offended a lot of girls in the quest to find a wife for Ekene. Don't you think so? Uncle me, Bulu Nemesis.
Neme what? Please, Mama, don't go there.
So, how was the exam today?
Very well, Mom.
Good to hear. You must be very tired. Just tell me what you want to have for a lunch. I want to fix it myself. While you go in there and freshen up.
Mom, I want to talk to you.
Talk to me? About what?
It is about Ekene and I.
Oh, Uloma, not again. What is it about you and Ekene?
Mother, please, I want you to help me talk to Daddy to reconsider his stand. I love Ekene so much, please. And he's the one I want to marry.
Uloma, how can you talk like this? Tell me, is Ekene the only man in this world? Can't you see better men out there?
There is no better man out there than Ekene. Mother, please. I love him. He's the man after my heart. Besides, when he gave me this ring, why did you say anything? Why are you people refusing us now?
Nobody is refusing Ekene.
It's just that your father thinks he's not the right man to inherit his wealth.
I am not interested in his wealth. He can keep his money. Mother, if I do not marry Ekene, I will remain unmarried. And I will run away to somewhere you can never find me.
Uloma, stop! What has come over you?
How can you talk like this? Can't you think about yourself, whom you are? How can you bring a nobody, a pauper, to come to this place and marry you and inherit everything we've worked for? Please, just go inside and freshen up, okay? I'll fix your food.
So, you are not going to help me talk to Daddy?
Okay, I will try, okay? I promise you, I will try. You know I love you so much. Alright? I don't want to see your tears. Just go in and freshen up. I promise to talk to your dad, okay? I promise. Please. Alright.
I don't want you to cry again, okay?
Wealth, no wealth. Nobody forced me to marry him, and he had nothing then.
Are you not done with this, your newspapers?
Is my newspaper disturbing you?
Not really. Just that I want to talk to you about something.
What is it?
I spoke with Uloma today.
You spoke with Uloma?
Yes.
About what?
About her marriage. My love, don't you think we should allow her to marry who she wants to marry? As for me, I think it's not right for you and I to interfere in her decisions. I mean, her private life. And it seems she's happy with this boy. So why not allow her to have her way? Please. Oh, you are not saying anything.
What else do you want me to say? I've said everything that needed to be said about this issue. The man that will marry my daughter is the man that will inherit everything I've labored for through bucket loads of sweat and not a fly-by-night opportunist, a gold digger that wants to cash into the spoils of war that he never fought in. Look, this is the last thing I will say about this issue. Look, if you want us to live in peace in this house, I don't want you to raise this issue again.
My love, how can you live in peace when your daughter is not happy? Okay, can't you make some sacrifice?
Enough!
You're working out on me. I'm talking about her happiness or her joy. Is it not still a man that will marry your daughter? Not even a woman. Eh? Your wealth, your money. Can't anybody come and marry her and inherit all these things?
He would listen to you. I spoke to Ekene. He sounded so broken and unhappy.
This means that you have nothing to do concerning what I told you yesterday.
Nani, what do you want us to do? Okay, please, we're going to do it. But please help me talk to Loma's father.
I will not go to his house in respect of this matter. I will not.
She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like...
He would listen to you. I spoke to Ekene. He sounded so broken and unhappy.
This means that you have nothing to do concerning what I told you yesterday.
Nani, what do you want us to do? Okay, please, we're going to do it. But please help me talk to Loma's father.
I will not go to his house in respect of this matter. I will not.
Baby me, I love you so much. But you see, the problem that I'm having now is that my father is maintaining the same position. And I'm tired of the whole of this shenanigan. Even I told my mother to help us talk to my father on our behalf. And she says, see, Yemi, there is nothing on this earth that will make your father change his mind. Nothing is paining me now.
Yemi. The thing now is not your father. The pro...
Oh, my brother-in-law. Michael.
How are you?
Hi. Good to see you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You mean, like I was saying, this whole thing is not about your father. It is about you. What is your stand?
Baby me, what do you mean by the what is my standee? Do you want me to lose my inheritance? See, if my father die now, everything belongs to me. And let me tell you, my father is suffering from a prostate cancer. And he will never last another 4 to 5 years. So if my father dies now, everything that my father has, all the money, will belong to me. And me and you will enjoy everything. Then I will marry you.
You do not get it, do you? Did I hear you clearly? Did you just say that I should wait for another 4 years? And then your father would die of his disease, his sickness, before we get married? Is that what you're saying?
Baby, me.
Please, I want to understand. Let me ask you a sincere question. Do you know how old I will be in the next 4 years?
You'll be 36 years old and I will still marry you because I've been waiting for you.
Because I love you. You will wait for me, Yemi?
Yes!
Sincerely?
Oh, no, no. I love her.
You will wait for me. And then in the next 4 years, you will go find yourself another Yoruba girl that suits you. And then you will leave me hanging on the shelf. Isn't it?
It's not like that, you see. Baby me, I love you very much. Eh? How can I leave you and go and marry another Yoruba girl? I always remember everything you have been doing for me. How you have always been there for me. How will I now forget all those things and go and marry another Yoruba girl? I will marry you, baby me.
Yemi,
baby.
Take a good look at me. I am a strong girl. Who can take anything that comes our way? In this field, I'm a professional that can fend for herself. Do
Do you understand me? Now, listen. If you cannot stand for yourself, if you cannot stand against your father and make him understand what you want, I do not think that you are the man for me.
Ah, baby.
Let me finish. You can go home, lie on your father's lap, suck your mother's breast, and please leave me the hell alone. You see this rubbish, this nonsense that we think we're having? It's over. I'm a very busy person. Do you understand?
Baby, me, it's bad for me. Please now, isn't it? I love you well. My please, baby, please don't be alone. Please, don't
Yemi, do this to me. Yemi, do you know that if people hear you talk, they will not know that you are up to 40 years. They will think it's one 20-something years old boy that is speaking.
It is your love that is intoxicating my...
You disgust me. When you are not talking nonsense, leave my office and lock my door.
Love that is interesting.
Right to call him a fool.
Any man who waits for his father to die so he can inherit is a compound fool.
Ekene, please. I don't have the strength for a quarrel. I don't have that strength right now, Biko. The long and short of the story is that I have ended the nonsense and whatever thing we're having, and that is it. Please help Maka, please.
Okay. Well, I'm just coming from Uloma's house.
My brother-in-law,
will you get out of this place with your sorry self?
This thing is not good, baby. I know you very well. If my father is not dying now, the money will come out.
Like I was saying, I'm just coming from Uloma's house. And the father chased me out and warned me never to be seen around there again. Now you just ended your own relationship with that thing. You see how the world turns around? We used to be the ones to reject everybody. Now we are being rejected by everybody. How old are you? How much time do you still have that you turn people down? Look at it. We keep rejecting people, now we are the ones who look like fools before the public. Continue with Mama. Keep rejecting people.
Do you and only my prayers and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. You no one else will do. You and only you.
Hello, can I? Why haven't you been picking your calls?
What is it? Why am I picking the call for?
Sweetheart, I have been calling you.
Listen to me, Uloma. Your father has warned me not to ever come close to you again, that we can't get married. Why don't you leave me alone to pick up my life and move on and make something out of my life? Why are you disturbing me? What is all this? You know this will lead us to nowhere. What is it? Please. Do not disturb my line again, I'm begging you.
Please, please, please don't do this to me. Please, you can't leave me now. Please. I am ready to risk my father's anger just to be with you. I do not care if he disowns me just to marry you. Please, you can't leave me now, not after everything we've been together. Please. Hello? Hello, are you there?
You're the answer to my prayers, and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you.
Uloma! Uloma!
Uloma just left with the car keys now. Are you not worried about her? What if something happens to her now? I'm talking to you.
Did I send her anywhere? Did I?
Is that all you have to say?
What else do you want me to say?
Me, I don't want anything to happen to my daughter. I don't want anything to happen to her.
Please, I want to rest.
Broke a bottle in your defense because I thought you loved me. Uloma.
Thank you, Jesus. Hey.
Hey, what have I done? Ekene will not destroy my home, oh Ekene.
I don't know what is going on. Honestly.
Sister, what do you mean by you don't know what is going on?
Isn't it? I don't know what is going on with you and Ekene. We've only said no to every girl Ekene brought home. Look at the Unoma we accepted. Her father is not helping matters. He has warned Ekene never to be seen with
his daughter.
I don't know. In all honesty, I don't know if God is trying to pay us in our own coins.
Rejection is not something anyone should go through. It is the worst feeling ever.
I came to see Mama. I didn't know you were around.
I came to see Mama too.
Oh, is she in?
Yeah, she's inside.
Oh, good. Ewoma, meet Ezine, my other sister. She's a medical doctor.
Wow.
Ezine, Ewoma.
Good afternoon.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Let's go and see Mama inside. This way. I like him so, 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 so. How I love good flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love good flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so, 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 so. How I love good flow, flow, flow. Anyhow she be living for me, cause I like him so.
Hello, Ezzy.
Sister. Sister, good afternoon. Are you still coming here this evening?
I'm already on my way. Is there any problem?
Perfect, sister. Please, hurry up and come here now because Ekene just walked in here.
Has he said anything why he wants to see us?
No. But
he came in here with one girl like that, looking like one mommy water.
You know, I think that is the reason.
Mommy water, kwa. Yeah.
Sister, sister, I'm not joking. You need to see this girl.
She is looking off just here from the rivers.
If this girl is working, on a cha, eh? What I don't understand is where Ekene goes to get all this kind of guests from.
Eh? He cannot just go somewhere, get a very good girl and marry a decent girl for a wife. I don't get it.
Even he said her name is Osino.
Iwoma. What kind of a frightening name is that?
That name is frightening now. Eh? Is that one a name?
Iwoma. Is that an Igbo name?
Yeah. Sister Ejukwam. How would I know? I don't know.
Don't worry. When I get to the house, I will see her. Has Mama seen her yet?
I don't know. They just walked inside now.
But do you know, if not for one thing, I would have stopped them from going inside.
They do not say, anything I started again. And Kaliko's here, but they won't enter. But just to avoid issues, I stayed back.
It's all right. Don't just do anything stupid, okay? Who knows, this one might be a decent one.
Hey, I wish. D. It won't matter. It's a decent. Where? Sister, come. I'm here waiting for you. Be fast. Biko. Biko.
Hear your mother.
I am moving out. Out.
You're moving out. And if I may ask,
Why are you moving out?
I am moving in with Ekene.
What? Ekene? Are you out of your mind?
I am out of my mind, Father. I am leaving before I completely lose it. I am moving in with the man who will help restore my sanity.
Now, will you put back those clothes before I descend on you?
Your threats do not scare me anymore. Right about now, I do not care what you do to me. But please, be fast about it, because nothing will stop me from being with the man I love.
Oh, Mama, will you shut up? What has come over you? Do you know the meaning of love? Oh, Mama, tell me, because you don't know exactly the gravity of what you're doing right now. You want to move in with that little boy that might end up dumping you tomorrow after using you.
I really do not care if I'm just his wife for an hour. It is better than the torture of being stopped by your prejudice and bigotry. Can't you people see that we're in love? Can't you people see that we make each other happy? Ekene isn't even interested in your money. Who told you he is interested in your money or class? He asked me to marry him before he discovered the daughter of who I was. If I do not leave this place tonight, I will end up killing myself and he will kill himself too. Then our blood shall be on your hands.
No. Oh, Mama, it has not gotten to that. Please. Please. Where do you think you're going? Eh? Eh? Now, will you put your butt on that bed before I beat the living daylight out of you?
Darling, please calm down. Please, calm down. Please, she's all I have. Just take it easy now. Take it easy. Please, darling, please. Please.
Please excuse us.
I should go. Excuse us. No, please. Just take it easy. Please.
Uloma, you know we have a way of discussing issues. So you have to wipe your tears so that we can talk. Okay? You mean you love this guy so much? And it's not one of your passing fads? And you love him so much that you want to be his wife? What of your exams? Your medical exams? You know, you are in the middle of your exams and my dream is for you to be a medical doctor. Are you willing to give up all that just because of this young man?
Being a medical doctor doesn't mean anything to me if Ekene isn't there.
Take it easy, okay? Wipe your tears. Wipe your tears, okay?
I know why you're here. Don't worry, I'll go and get it for you. as if I knew you were coming.
Ah, thank you for having me.
Okay. I'm coming, eh?
Thank you, ma.
Hey, it's about God, madam. What's up, we like
it? Ah, mama, thank you, mama.
Oh, but you like it, we. That means you're a good man.
Okay, mama, ah, thank you.
I'll get it.
How do I start now, Safe? Ah, this thing I want to tell you, man. Something about Ezine.
Yes. But finish your food first, then we'll talk about Ezine.
Oh, thank you, Mami.
What is in Conwelia?
Ah, Mami, you are a good cook.
I know.
Mami. Miss, can I get extra pepper from this?
Extra pepper again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
You know, mommy used to put pepper for us when they put us in
front. I will get the pepper. I'm going to work out here, but I'm going to go.
Mommy, thank you, ma'am.
I will get the
I'm very sorry. You see, it is not my fault. You see, I love Ezine very, very much. It is my father that is the problem.
It's your father. It is not your fault. You fell out there, mate.
So you knew you wanted to boot my daughter, yet you came here, sat down, eating my rice, and asking for extra pepper.
Mommy, I actually wanted to tell you before I eat. You said I should go on first. That when I finish.
Ibrahu, when you knew what you were here for, you decided to finish eating. So your father thinks that an Igbo girl, an educated one for that matter, is not good enough for you, okay?
Why can't anyone understand me now, eh? You should allow my father to disinherit me.
To disinherit you? You're disinherited from here. Get out. Get up and get out.
Mama, now I came here now to beg you to help me bring Ezine back. Now, to meet my
father. You can't wipe me here. You know, you can't cap me. You bring Ezine back. Are you not the one that married this small man? Make him rap. Look at him, he's a blue. Come and get into this guy and get out.
My inheritance is.
I'm off here. Yeah. Inheritance. What time we got? I have a chase. Believe I said that, one cup.
If we are late.
Come up here. Pablo, what are they? I'm a son of whatever.
You see how men are? You see how they are? They are very wicked, even the tiniest of them. They will use you, then they dump you. Nekira, awa my friend debe. You just said your blue one with a kid, okay? Eh? You allowed him to you know, on your body. I don't even want to say alone. I warned you that little men are very troublesome. You said no. You said you could carry him and do whatever. Nani ano? See the result. Now he's the one that has carried you. And look at you, he overused you. He overused you. I don't know why you didn't make you loyal. You regularly need a tree run over. We never want to know, Lily.
Ha!
to the nonsense, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I wanna spend my whole life with you.
You, you know what else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers, and yes to the nonsense, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life.
I don't just know why they will not understand me. Eh? Selfish people. See now, will they feed me if I lose my inheritance? Will they? This isn't the people. Eh? Now, if I lose my father's inheritance now, what will now live to survive in future?
What is wrong with the man?
Nothing. Nothing is wrong with him. It's not his fault.
Whose fault is it then? He's the one who is not seeing what his daughter is going through.
It is your fault. It is Mama's fault. It is Ezine's fault. You were the ones who always rejected everybody I brought. Oria, every single girl I presented before you, you turned her down. Now we have become the people whom everybody rejects now. And you are asking me whose fault is it? Like you don't know? Continue. Ologonu. And you did a good thing by shedding off that good-for-nothing boy, because you don't need a boy like that. You need a proper man. Somebody who can stand his ground and build a home. Not one who would always crawl back to his father to beg for crumbs and I'm waiting for some inheritance. Imagine the cheek of it.
Please tell Uloma that I would love to see her.
You did not hear when I told you that the father warned me sternly not to ever cross their house again. That if I continued my relationship with the daughter, he would disown her. You know wrong when I get that one. He said, "Muje kwazo, gebe lunishi."
Olugo to.
Olugo we gabe. Olu mukina choka njia ba yare lele. Oka ne bido bido. Okay, Uloma. Okay.
Very worried by now.
What should I do? I think you should go and look for him.
No, mommy. Not after everything I said last night.
Don't sound that way. Eh? He would want to see you. Yes. Just go and look for him, please. Okay?
Can I make use of your car?
Why not? You know where my car keys are. Just go. Okay? Please.
Alright, mommy.
I just want you to take things easy. Alright? Don't stress yourself.
You know, your father is very difficult and you really need to be patient in following him.
It's okay, mother.
Okay? Just take it easy, okay?
I will, mother.
To my prayers, and yes to the no says, and there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I
want to spend my whole life with you. You no one else will do. You and only you. You're the answer to my prayers and yes to the no says. And there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. I want to spend my whole life with you. To my prayers and yes to the no says. And there's nothing I won't do to be beside you. She know this, she know that. As a matter of fact, I like that. Now she be my one and only, my super baby. She did this how, she did that how, but I cannot leave her now. You better mind yourself, let my baby be that to you. I'm so. I like how I love got it flow. Anyhow she be living for me. Cause I like I'm so. How I love got it flow. Anyhow she be living for me. Cause I like I'm so.
I like I'm so.
Flow. Anyhow, she be living for me. Cause I like I'm so.